Food processing facility sanitation is an integral part of good manufacturing practices. Effective sanitation aids in ensuring the wholesomeness, safety, and quality of shell eggs. The negative impacts on food safety and egg quality are a result of microbial growth. Research has shown that ineffective cleaning and sanitation practices or programs can lead to reduced quality duration or potential product contamination. Residual microorganisms can lead to egg spoilage or foodborne illness. Most of this training series will focus on the United States Department of Agriculture, Agricultural Marketing Service pre-operational sanitation inspection expectations. However, remember that the Food and Drug Administration has oversight of consumer shell eggs in the United States, as stated in 21 CFR 117. Additionally, customers, accrediting organizations, such as Safe Quality Food, British Retail Consortium Global Standard, and others, as well as state and local regulatory agencies, may have additional facility sanitation expectations that can impact your facility. AMS sanitation requirements are meant to protect the integrity of the USDA grade mark by requiring additional sanitation expectations at facilities that utilize AMS voluntary grading services. To meet these goals, AMS inspectors will assess for voluntary grading program requirements during the pre-operational sanitation inspection and throughout processing operations by utilizing organoleptic inspection assessments. While AMS may review microbial test results as part of certain export programs, AMS does not conduct nor require swabbing or biological testing during routine sanitation assessments. So what is organoleptic inspection? Organoleptic inspection assessments include sight, smell, and touch. However, microbial growth will not always be seen, smelled, or felt. Critical areas are defined as equipment with potential surface contact with eggs or come in contact with wash water or air blown to dry the eggs. Non-critical areas are defined as areas that are not likely to imminently affect product quality. Non-critical does not mean it is not important. Non-critical unsatisfactory conditions should be addressed after the processing line has been started, unless unable to safely do so during processing. In this module, the critical and non-critical areas of the egg drying equipment will be identified and discussed. Egg processing facilities shall be thoroughly cleaned at the end of each operating day. The term reasonably clean is applied during the egg processing shift to indicate that equipment and processing areas are maintained with minimum egg meat accumulation. More explanation of these terms is presented in the introduction module. All eggs processed under USDA Agricultural Marketing Service must be reasonably dry before packaging. This is usually accomplished with egg drying equipment. The egg drying equipment within the egg processing facility must be clean each day prior to processing. As of January 2020, all portions of the egg drying equipment that generate, disperse, or divert the air to the eggs, as well as the rollers, are critical. This would include filters and screens associated with the blower unit. USDA Agricultural Marketing Service inspectors should inspect egg drying equipment, including blower units and filters, daily. All portions of the egg drying equipment within the egg processing facility must be open, available, and accessible for assessment during pre-operational sanitation inspection. Doors and panels should be open or removed from the egg drying equipment to allow for effective inspection of the unit. Facilities with overhead egg drying equipment should work with AMS local supervisors to come up with a safe assessment method for their particular system, which could include utilizing cameras, video, or other assessment methods. Temporary elevated platforms used in sanitation assessments should be designed to safely support personnel by reducing the risk of falling and preventing unstable conditions. Common ladders and stools not specifically designed for safety in the food processing environment should not be used for assessment. Filters located in ceilings or on roofs should be presented to the inspectors upon request. Filters should never be placed directly on the processing room floor. Any parts removed from equipment should be placed on a clean, non-porous surface. Critical portions of the egg drying equipment would include filters and screens, baffles and air knives, interior panel surfaces, spools or rollers that pass through the egg drying equipment. Air entering the blower must be filtered. Filters range from fabric screens to disposable fiber filters to reusable washable filters. Depending on facility design, blower motors and the corresponding filters may be located on the processing line, in a dedicated room, in the ceiling, or even on the roof. Within the blower unit, baffles and air knives direct the flow of air onto the egg surface. Baffles can be made of metal or polymer with a variety of designs. Both sides of the baffle are considered critical since air coming in contact with the baffle will subsequently contact the egg surface. Spools or rollers that transport the eggs through the drying equipment are subjected to high pressure air. Any loose debris are likely to be dislodged and have a high potential of egg contact. Non-critical components of egg drying equipment would include fan housing, motors, filter housing, electrical conduit, areas below the rollers, any supporting exterior structures. One design for accomplishing egg drying is the use of large circular fans mounted directly over the egg processing line. This setup still requires air filtration, which has been accomplished in these shots by the use of fine weave fabric filters placed on the air intake side of the fan. Both the filter and fan components must be clean and ready for assessment before operations begin. In this shot, both the filters and fan systems are satisfactory in a critical area. Some egg drying processes will use multiple units and baffle styles to accomplish egg drying. The front unit in this shot is called an air knife. It uses a baffle that directs air over the eggs at a sharp angle to cut water off the egg surface before the egg enters the second drying unit. Baffles in the second unit will present air directly onto the egg to complete the drying process. Air knife units will have their own blowers and filters that will need to be assessed independent from the rest of the egg drying equipment. In this shot, a square filter is located just above the blower unit of the air knife. Due to the location of the filter, plant personnel would need to present the air knife filter to the USDA AMS grader for assessment. Although the filter cannot be seen in this shot, it would be the critical component. The exterior, non-critical housing and blower motor seen in this shot is satisfactory. Here we see another style of egg drying equipment with all components located entirely on the processing line. In this example, the critical filters are found in the square filter housing above the air knife blower and to the right of the blower unit. Due to the location of the filters, plant personnel would need to present filters to the USDA AMS grader for inspection. The filter presented in this shot is unsatisfactory due to buildup of dust and debris. Please note, freshly cleaned or new filters that come in contact with the processing room floor would be deemed unsatisfactory. Here is another type of egg drying equipment that is connected to the egg processing line. This type of unit provides easier access to the filters for assessment. Baffles on these units are accessed from the opposite side of the fans. The critical filters on this unit are satisfactory. The non-critical exterior components of this unit appear to be satisfactory also. Here we see a type of egg drying equipment that does not have all components located on the processing line. This type of equipment will store the fans and motors in an alternate location and transport the forced air through large pipes. Care must be taken to assess both the portions located on the processing line as well as the portions in the alternate location, such as fans and motors. Here we see an egg drying fan unit with an unsatisfactory critical filter. The filter on this unit would need to be cleaned or replaced before operations begin. Additionally, the non-critical fan housing and motor are unsatisfactory due to buildup of dust and debris. This would need to be corrected during the next cleaning and sanitation cycle. Here we see examples of satisfactory and unsatisfactory critical filters. The filter on the left has obvious buildup of dust and foreign material and should be replaced or cleaned before use. The filter on the right looks to be adequately cleaned and is satisfactory for use. Although the filter on the right looks newer, all filters here would be considered satisfactory for use. In addition to the critical filter, the interior component of the fan housing is also critical and should be assessed. Here we see the buildup of dust and debris on the interior compartment of the fan housing. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding and should be corrected before processing begins. Fan units may be located in areas away from the processing line. If blower units are located without safe, easy access, facility management should work with the USDA AMS supervisor to determine the best methods for assessment. In egg drying equipment, baffles are located between the blower output and the rollers. Baffles are critical on all surfaces and can be assessed either removed from the drying unit or in place with appropriate lighting. This air knife baffle appears to be satisfactorily cleaned on the visible surface. Here we see an unsatisfactory condition within the critical egg drying unit. Egg meat is observed on the center divider as well as on the baffle mount. The upper portion of the baffles in the main drying unit would be a critical area. Both are satisfactorily clean. This is another unsatisfactory example of the interior of an egg drying unit. While the stainless steel reflects a lot of yellow from the rollers below, what makes this unsatisfactory is the residual egg meat and debris that remains along the stainless steel brace and the underside of the baffle. The fan housing, motors, filter housing, electrical conduit, and any supporting exterior structures are non-critical areas and appear to be satisfactorily cleaned. The area of the drying equipment below the eggs is non-critical. However, it is still expected to be clean. Here we see eggshell remaining on the framing structure and pan under the drying equipment. This would be an unsatisfactory finding in a non-critical area. Here we see the same area after thorough cleaning and it is satisfactory. Furthermore, we see the structural components of cross members which are satisfactorily clean and non-critical. While the portion of the egg drying equipment located under the rollers is non-critical, an exception to this would be clean-in-place brushes that come in contact with the spools during operation. These brushes would be considered critical. The egg meat left in the brushes would be critical, unsatisfactory, while the severity of the residual egg on the rest of the non-critical components would raise it to an unsatisfactory finding as well. All equipment and surfaces involved in the generation and dispensing of air onto clean eggs are considered critical in pre-operational sanitation inspection. While portions of the egg drying equipment below the rollers that transport the eggs through the system are non-critical components, these portions should be cleaned at the end of the processing day.